Hi, this is Ajay Anand and welcome to science classes from excelup.com. In this lesson, you will learn about the five kingdom classification of living beings. This lesson has been taken from biology of class 11th. You will learn about the difference between prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Then you will learn about some key features of five kingdoms and a couple of examples of living beings from each kingdom. The five kingdom classification was proposed by Robert Whittaker in 1969, and this is the most accepted system of classification of living beings. Robert Whittaker proposed five kingdoms, and the name of these kingdoms are Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae, and Animalia. Before going into details of these kingdoms, let us divide living beings on the basis of structure of nucleus. So there are two groups, prokaryotes and eukaryotes. In case of prokaryotes, the genetic material is not organized and is not membrane bound. So, nuclear membrane is absent in prokaryotes, and in case of eukaryotes, genetic material is bound by nucleus. So, nuclear membrane is present. The kingdom Monera comes under prokaryotes, and rest of the kingdoms, they come under eukaryotes. Monera is commonly known as bacteria. All the bacteria, they belong to this kingdom. The key features of the kingdom Monera are: cell wall is present, and cell wall is made of peptidoglycan. Bacteria can be autotrophic and heterotrophic. Those which are heterotrophic, they are parasites or saprophytes, and autotrophic bacteria, they can be chemosynthetic or photosynthetic. Bacteria are found almost everywhere on earth, and many bacteria, they are found on the body or inside the body of living beings. Bacteria can be classified on the basis of shapes, and they are cocci, bacilli, vibrio and spirilla. Among eukaryotes, we can further classify them as unicellular and multicellular. As the name suggests, organisms which are made of just a single cell, they are called unicellular. And those organisms which have more than one cell in their body are called multicellular organisms. The kingdom Protista, it contains all the unicellular organisms, and rest of the kingdoms, they contain multicellular organisms. Some key features of Protista are: cell wall is present or absent. Some protists have flagella or cilia for locomotion. They can be autotrophic or heterotrophic in terms of mode of nutrition. Reproduction can be sexual or asexual. Here are some examples of Protista, like Euglena, Paramecium, Amoeba. Kingdom Fungi. Cell wall is present in fungi, and the cell wall in fungi is made of chitin. Yeast is a fungi which is unicellular, and other fungi, they are multicellular and they are filamentous. Fungi are found almost everywhere. They are heterotrophs and they can be saprophyte or parasite. Reproduction in fungi is sexual or asexual. These are some examples of fungi. This is yeast, which is unicellular. This is agaricus, and it is commonly known as mushroom. It is multicellular. Then rhizopus or bread mold, which grows on stale bread or fruit, is an example of fungi. Kingdom Plantae. Cell wall is present in plants, and the cell wall in plants is made of cellulose. Chlorophyll is present in those cells in plants which are responsible for photosynthesis. And the plantae are autotrophs, and they carry out photosynthesis for making food. Some of the plants, they can be semi-photosynthetic or semi-autotrophs, like parasitic plants or insectivorous plants. Insectivorous plants, they depend on insects for the required protein. Reproduction can be sexual or asexual. One of the salient features of plant is alternation of generation, which means that there is an alternation between haploid and diploid phase in the life cycle of plant. Haploid means half the number of chromosomes in cells, and diploid means double the number of chromosomes in cells. Animalia. In case of animals, cell wall is absent. Animals are heterotrophic, and they follow holozoic mode of nutrition, which means that animals ingest food and the digestion is carried out inside the body of animals. Animals show different levels of organization, and it can be tissue level or organ level or organ system level, depending on the complexity of animal. Reproduction is sexual, and most of the animals, they are capable of locomotion, that is, they can move from one place to another place. So there are thousands of animals. These pictures, they show some examples of animals like elephant, snail, and frog. To recapitulate, I talked about the prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Then I talked about unicellular and multicellular living beings. Then I talked about the key features of five kingdoms, that is Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae, and Animalia. That's all for this lesson. Thank you.